Okay, I got my trusty old Makita drill. I bet I've had this thing for 20 years probably. It's a model, maybe 15 years, but it's a model 6510 LVR, and this is just indestructible. I'll tell you what, I'm not saying anything about Harbor Freight. I have a lot of Harbor Freight things, but well, this drill has been good. So I'm just gonna ream these holes out. Got a lot of cutting oil in there. Something in there. So that should be right where I want it now for the tap. Quarter by 20, and we'll start tapping. Just take your time, kind of make sure you're going in straight. I wasn't there. Using a bar like this is the best thing, as opposed to a wrench. So you can put pressure on both sides. Get her started nice and easy. Make sure you're going straight. Make sure you take nice deep cut before you back it up for the first time. Going in nice and straight. Back her up. Need to back this up and make sure you get all these filings out. And so you'll cut better. Throw a little more oil in there. So you can see now you got a nice threaded hole in there. Be so bad working on this engine, except it still smells like a zoo. But yeah. And I'll start the other one. This one started a lot easier. I'll clean that hole up. And we'll get those bolts in. All right, so I've got these bolts in and tightened down, and then I've snugged this one up to bring this bar up. And now as I tighten this bolt up, it'll pull this whole fixture up, and usually comes off with a big pop, so we'll see. I'm getting the flywheel turning, so I may have to use the impact wrench. Because I don't want my fingers in there. And I don't want to hold the flywheel. Best thing actually to do, but I've already taken off the blade, is to put a piece of wood to block the blade from turning, but I can't do that now. So I may have to use the impact wrench. Alright, and it's good to lubricate these threads if you're especially if you're going to use the impact wrench. Get a little lubrication down those threads. And it doesn't take long. A little too much. Let's try that. Nice and easy. There it comes. So yeah, there's a bunch of nests under there now. I don't know if you can see, but magnets are all rusted up. We'll have to clean all that up. But so I'll show you what we got here for more crud under there. So I'm gonna take this out again and blow it out again for the fifth time. There's a lot of stuff in there. I haven't been able to get it. It's just wedged in there, and it's just nasty, just gunked up in there. So next we'll deal with this intake assembly right here, and then we'll pull the engine. Alright, I took the air cleaner off and the air cleaner air cleaner cover off and the air cleaner. Here's the base for it, and there's 1, 2, 3 bolts, it looks like, or nuts, bolts here that I have to undo, and get those out of the way, and we'll take this off. That'll lead us into the carburetor, and that'll, but you want to get this off so you can see what's holding all of the carburetor, the whole assembly, onto the engine block, and then you want to separate that. And then I got this thing turned on its side. While I have it on its side, we'll come down in here and we'll separate the engine from the lawnmower deck with 1, 2, 3 bolts here, and then I'll open up the oil drain from the bottom, make sure all the oil is drained out before I start working on it. Alright, here's the carburetor assembly, and one of the things you want to do is make note of this linkage that's right here. I'm pointing to it, and how it is hooked up. If you have to take pictures, I could probably use this video to determine how it was put on. I don't know if it's clear enough to be able to use that, but I took the carburetor assembly off now. There's 3 bolts. One right there, another one right there, and a third one on the bottom side here. Then this simply slides off like this, and so now it's separated from the intake. And now that you can see, there's a rubber grommet that came off the intake. You got to make sure that that goes on the back side of that carburetor. And then you just separate this linkage here, and you should be able to pull this whole assembly off. Just tilt this up and the linkage comes off. So kind of keep that all together. It goes just like that, and until we get ready to deal with it, there's the three bolts that attached it, and I'm going to put this O-ring along with it. And you know what I like to do as I'm assembling or disassembling any project, I've already bagged a bunch, everything I've taken off so far, I will take a Ziploc bag and I'll mark what it is, throw it all in there, all the bolts that attach to it, everything. And then as I'm putting it back together or cleaning each individual component up, I'll have it. So this is the throttle, which you can see is really gummed up. I'm gonna have to clean that, but that's separate. And so now I'll take this drive off. Alright, I backed off this bolt here that holds this gear drive cover on. Pull that out. And then right here is a tab which you have to push in. And when you push it in, it lifts the cover up. And there's the belt drive for the front wheel.
All I did was slide that belt off the pulley now, so there's no, should be no tension on the engine. And now I'll turn it over on its side again, and we'll get those bolts off, unbolt the motor from the deck. All right, I've got an impact socket here. And what I had to do, because it's so rusty, and you want to make sure if you're using the impact gun that you get that that socket on that bolt head solidly. Otherwise, it's going to strip it out, and then you'll have a real hell of a time getting it out. So I just hammered that down a few taps until it seats. You can hear it seat. Socket. Reverse. And here it comes. Actually, what I meant to do was actually leave it in there and rock that sock, the impact off while it's still in there, so I can use it. But of course it won't come off. There we go. Yeah. Now it's off. And I'll wire brush these. I may even get new ones just because these get so rusted and corroded over the years. And you don't want these to strip and never get your engine done. So again, you know, I'll take this one and you can kind of hear it when it bottoms out. And then have it set up for reverse, backing out. And leave it in there a little bit. You see that engine's already loose. I want to make sure I don't back this one up too much. Okay, that's all I want to do. I need to get something to catch that engine when it comes off. I'll just take this by hand and hold the engine. It's a pretty small motor. Alright, and there it is, 10-pound baby boy.